Yo, what's up, YouTube? It's your boy, Samurai, coming back with another video. Can't thank you guys enough for the continued support over the past couple of days. I think it's incredible, you know, that the channel is growing so quickly. I'm looking to get 1,000 subscribers, maybe 4 to 6 months. Can we make that happen? I think we can make that happen. I'm thinking some giveaways coming up. I'm thinking possibly opening up a Discord, a Patreon, you know, just want to make this a little community. I would love to get everyone involved and us all be a part of this little group and, you know, enjoy giving recommendations to each other. You guys know a lot of music that I don't know. That's why you're recommending them. And I also probably know a lot of music that you don't know. So I am actually starting a little segment. I hope you guys will enjoy. It's going to be called Album of the Week. Maybe Album of the Day. I'm not sure. You guys let me know in the comments what you would prefer. I just feel like Album of the Day would be a lot of albums to pick from. So I just feel like weekly would make it a little bit easier. And to start off, I have here my favorite album of my favorite band. This album means a lot to me. If you guys don't know this, this is Wish You Were Here by Pink Floyd. An incredible, incredible album. I will admit, I don't think this is their best, but it's my favorite. And actually, a funny story about that album. When I was in the hospital 4 years ago, 2017, I had appendicitis and I had to get it removed, and I had to get a CT scan or whatever, CAT scan. I don't know, whichever one is the one that takes like forever, like 40 minutes or something. And they gave me the option. They were like, do you want to listen to music? We have some headphones for you. I was like, sure. And for whatever reason, I just picked that album just because I love it. It's actually really funny just because the second track on the album is called Welcome to the Machine. And here I was inside this big machine making all these noises, feeling very uncomfortable. And then the song just comes on and it kind of describes perfectly, not lyrically, but emotionally how I felt at the time. So that made me like this album that much more. What was funny also is that the scanning ended as soon as the album ended. It was like perfect. It was like the perfect album for that. It was ridiculous. You know, that was a terrible experience for me overall. I was in the hospital for about 3 weeks and I had to go back 3 different times. So it was just a rough kind of time for me. That album helped me get through a lot of that. So it's a really special album for me. If you guys are not familiar with this album or the band in general, I would check it out. I mean, if you guys are watching my Tool reactions, you most likely already know Pink Floyd. If you don't, you'll most likely like it. This album may not play as effortlessly as maybe Dark Side of the Moon. I think that's their kind of perfect album. And obviously, I mean, it's, you know, it's widely known. Everybody knows the symbol. Everybody has heard it. But this one right here holds a special place in my heart. They all do, really, all their 1970s albums. Dark Side of the Moon would probably come second after this one. And maybe they're tied. I don't know. It's hard to pick, really. But this is an incredible album. Incredible landscapes. Incredible engineering. The sounds that they use, especially Rick Wright's synthesizers and like Welcome to the Machine are absolutely so like mind-blowing. It's unlike anything I've ever heard on anything else. And the fact that this came out in 75, is ridiculous. I don't know how they were able to do that kind of stuff back then. But it's an album dedicated to their lost group member, Syd Barrett. So the starting and the finishing track, which is one long track made up of 9 parts, Shine on You Crazy Diamond is his first name, Sid. So Shine You Diamond, Shine on You Crazy Diamond is dedicated to him. But mostly the whole album in general is about the music industry and their struggles with it, and you know, maybe even capitalism. And Sid definitely struggled with that kind of stuff, being famous and handling that. I don't think he ever really wanted to be famous. And once he left the group, they kind of broke out and, you know, saw worldwide stardom. And then they kind of circled back to their founding member and made this in memory of him. And funny story, actually, while they were recording Shine On You Crazy Diamond, he walked into the studio after not seeing them for like decades, looking fat and completely different than what he was before. He kind of went off the deep end after taking a lot of substances. And yeah, it's just a great album with a lot of different kinds. There's only 5 songs on here, but there's a lot of different sounds. You got Shine On You Crazy Diamond, which the beginning one and then the ending Shine On You Crazy Diamond sound completely different. They give you 2 different feels. You got Welcome to the Machine, which is a crazy, insane track about the industry in general, but mostly the music industry. And the synthesizers, dude, in that song are mind-blowing. It's like they come out of the speakers. It's incredible. Have a Cigar is a nice little track as well. It's not my favorite in the album. And then, of course, you got the title track, Wish You Were Here, which is, I mean, everybody knows that song, and I think it's relatable to mostly anyone who hears it. So you guys let me know if you like this little segment. I would love to keep doing these, but I think I'm going to stick to the album of the week thing. So I'll start out with all my favorite albums and be ready for extreme changes from this to some underground rap, you know, to then some Brazilian music. It's going to be all over the place, but I want to give you guys some of the stuff that you may not have heard, you know, so we can all share music together. So anyways, let's get to today's reaction, which is Jet City Woman. This was, let me see. PongGod. All right, so without further ado, let's get to today's reactions, which is Queensryche. I have no idea how to say that. You guys let me know in the comments below. Jet City Woman, this was a track suggested by PongGod, so shout out to you, PongGod. I appreciate it. I've heard of this name before. I'm not familiar with this band at all. I don't think I've ever heard any of their songs. But let's give it a go. Let's see what we got here. I'm not sure what to expect. I think he said it was kind of hard rock, maybe. Let's take a listen, shall we? Alrighty. Let me start recording here. Bam. Bam. All right. And boom. I like that bass off rip. Kick drum's got a little bit of ambiance in it. Oh, nice.
time I leave, you say you won't be there. And
okay.
You're always there. Every time I cry your name at night, you pull close and say it's alright. I look in your eyes.
Alright, so I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that this is some glam metal kind of stuff, hair metal kind of style. I would assume this is probably from the 80s. It sounds very 80-ish based off of the reverb from the drums. Not that intense like how some songs from the 80s are, but it's definitely got that kind of feel. But I like the way the drums sound so far. They got a lot of ambiance with them, and the singer sounds pretty good. So let's keep going here. Jet City Woman.
Just like the rain, washing me red, wash over me. Touching your face, I feel the heat of your heartbeat echoing my head like a scream.
It kind of sounds like Geddy Lee right there for a second. This is such an 80s chorus right here. You know what I mean? Like, it's good though. I like it.
Jet City.
Love the melodic guitars.
I'm thinking there's a part missing from my life. Wonder where I'd be without your love. Holding me together now. Watching the time tick away. Face grows longer every day.
I love the use of the reverb and the delay effects on this. It's very subtle, but it's nice. Give me that solo, come on. This has got to be from the 80s.
Stop!
comes the Jet City Woman. Okay. Overall, really cool track. I would love... this is kind of a track that I would like to listen to if I had, like, a convertible and I'm driving down, like, a little highway and I'm just chilling by myself with some sunglasses, my girl to the side. That's in the summertime. Like, that's definitely the kind of vibes that I got from that. I will say it's very 80-ish sounding. Like, it's something about the 80s that has, like, a very unique, not unique sound, but its own really distinct sound. I like the song overall. I would maybe, as a stylistic choice, I would bring up maybe the drums a bit, specifically the snare. I felt like the snare was really ducked in the mix. I felt like it come up a little bit. I love the way the vocals were mixed and the harmonies. Yeah, great use of reverb. The splashes in the drums sounded a little, or the cymbals in the drums sounded maybe a little bit too splashy. If that makes sense, maybe it was overly compressed or something. But I feel like it lacks some impact overall. Yeah, but cool song. Really cool song. You guys let me know how to say that band name. I have no idea. And where they're from. They sound like they're from an English-speaking country. So I would assume it's probably the U.S. or like Canada or something. But that name is definitely like German or something. I don't know. But cool. Cool song. Definitely cool song. Not something I would listen to a whole lot. I feel like I would have to be in the mood to listen to this kind of stuff. I'm not huge on 80s music. There's not a whole lot of 80s music that I listen to for some reason. I just don't like how they drowned everything in so much reverb, especially the drums. Like, obviously, Phil Collins in the Air Tonight. Like, that's a prime example of 80s drum sounds. Like, that's what it sounded like. But very cool. I like the guitar solo. Definitely gave me, like, some Slash vibes. Kind of style. But cool deal, man. So you guys let me know. Any more recommendations down at the bottom? I should be at work right now. a couple reactions don't hurt. Am I right? So, once again, thank you guys so much. Let's get this channel rolling, man. Let's get this channel popping. Let's go. It's only up from here. And I hope I see more of you guys, and I hope to see the ones that I've spoke to, return and watch my other videos, and you guys can request more things. And yeah, I think that's about it for this video. Yeah, hope you guys enjoy. And if you do, please make sure to hit that like, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so you don't miss any videos such as this one. You guys feel free to check out my other music and my covers on my YouTube video and also my other reaction videos. I do mixing and mastering services as well for $100. So, you know, if you're interested and you have some music that you need mixed and mastered, feel free to send it my way or just message me for more information. Yeah, without further ado, thank you guys so much. And Samurai is clocking out. Peace.